According to what the people want.
But there was an 8% drop on the issue of graft and corruption.
Well, I think it's really due to the high expectations of people. No? And those that have worked in the government would easily attest that it's not that easy to just do away completely with graft and corruption in 9 or 10 months in public office.
That must have been a disappointment, though. I mean, this administration was elected primarily because of its platform on good governance and on eradicating graft and corruption, and this is one of the biggest drops in terms of satisfaction ratings.
Well, there are still institutional hurdles. As you know, the Office of the Ombudsman has been pointed to repeatedly by this administration as a clear obstacle. Mm-hmm. And it was only recently when we witnessed the impeachment and later on the resignation of the Ombudsman. Mm-hmm. But I think it would be more fair, no, to look at the entire spectrum of issues that the President has addressed. Nobody is mentioning economics. No? When if we look at the key indicators of the economy, the first quarter saw a big decline in the budget deficit. Mm-hmm. We only had a budget deficit of 26 billion mm-hmm. compared to the budgeted amount of 112 billion. Mm-hmm. We have reduced the deficit considerably in less than a year, and we're looking to reduce it further because of the improvement in revenues and because of the less than budgeted expenditures in government. There are really many accomplishments on many fronts that need to be highlighted, Gigi.
But graft and corruption, really, I think people still waiting to see some progress on that front. And yesterday, when the Sandigan Bayan handed down its decision that it was approving the plea bargaining agreement between General Carlos Garcia and the Office of the Ombudsman, how did that impact, you think, on the efforts of this government to fight corruption?
We have been warning against such eventuality. You know? We have been exposing the irregularity, you know, that the plea bargain represented. And despite that, no, we have done our best. Almost every other week, charges were filed against big-time smugglers and tax evaders. And this was never seen in the previous regime.
Charged, but not yet.
We have a process. We have a process.
It hasn't gone beyond that.
Yeah, because we have a process. We're still a government of laws.
Do you think that the decision of the Sandigan Bayan yesterday, do you think the government took a big hit when that came out?
That is definitely a setback, Gigi. To me, this is still tied to the issue of the former ombudsman. Mm-hmm. No? And, you know, probably the president also gave enough time for the former ombudsman to shape up. No, that's mm-hmm. probably the reason why it took time before the ruling party actually took positive action towards the former ombudsman. And supposedly our main discussions would be on the impending impeachment proceedings in the Senate. No, mm-hmm. but now that she resigned, of course, the Senate can now move forward. And, you know, the point really is, whether we like it or not, in any government, graft and corruption is really an issue. Mm-hmm. No? And actually, probably one of the reasons why so many would also think that the president is a single issue president is because, while, you know, you're hitting on graft and corruption and knowing that, of course, it takes time before you can really have
results.
A dent on or see results mm-hmm. on this issue, probably we can also look into other programs. Mm-hmm. Ito yung dapat na i-communicate. I'm sure, of course, that there are some programs that are there, no, but needs to be further discussed publicly.
Of course, the one that took an even bigger hit in terms of the satisfaction ratings was the issue of foreign policy, foreign affairs. It went down by 11%. What do you think happened there?
Well, the survey was conducted during the first week of March.
Right. Yeah.
And we know that in the weeks before that, there was a lot of relocation and repatriation problems involving our overseas Filipino workers in the Middle East, mm-hmm. Particularly in Egypt and then Libya. Mm-hmm. I was pointing out earlier to you, Gigi, you know, that we have a very lean embassy staff, you know, of 25 to 30 people. And they had to move more than 10,000 Filipinos mm-hmm. in Libya alone.
Mm-hmm. But so it was probably really the lack of foresight that...
well, we could have been better prepared, no? But the sheer magnitude of the problem was really quite daunting. No? Mm-hmm. And we still did our best. And to the credit of our new Foreign Affairs Secretary, Albert Del Rosario, mm-hmm. he really employed a very hands-on approach. No? And I think from then on, there's been... a lot of stability introduced into the picture, and I think if this factor is rated anew, we'll definitely fare better.
The survey was taken, as Secretary Coloma said, it was taken March 4 to 7. But do you think that that issues that happened before that, like, do they stick in the minds of people when they're responding to these surveys, or do Pinoys have a very quick memory?
I'm not really sure.
Like, would the hostage crisis have played yeah. still in the minds of people?
You know, the hostage crisis to me is still very fresh in our memories, not so much because of the, you know, the controversy that it elicited, but more also of the after effects. Hong Kong government demanding a significant part in the fight for justice mm-hmm. or looking for justice. But apart from that also, you mentioned about the lack of foresight. This really, to me, is really important. In the budgeting for 2011, for example, I'd like to mention that the DFA budget has been cut significantly. Mm-hmm. So this has really affected, you know, of all the departments, to me, the Department of Foreign Affairs is a very professional department. I'm not saying, of course, the other departments aren't, no? But what I'm saying is that the officers of this department really go through the same rigors, probably, if not more, compared to the other departments, like even the military. Mm-hmm. Pero ito din yung departamento na pag may nag-retire doon ipapasok. So, mm-hmm. kawawa naman yung mga career service officials. Mm-hmm. Not to mention also that in terms of operation, I know this personally because of I know some friends from the department, nagagamit din nila yung personal na pera nila. So mm-hmm. that is also one of the reasons why we failed significantly, no, in the action protecting the our OFWs, no. At least ito, nakita natin concretely kung gaano ka-importante ang DFA, not only in terms of representing the country, but also in, you know, representing our countrymen outside the country.
Do you think this administration can still recover, or is it safe to assume that it should be expected that the ratings will continue to decline? Level the expectations, as he said.
Well, I'm glad Edmund here mentioned budget, Gigi. No? We came into office at the end of June 2010, and the budget hearing started in July and August of last year. By the time, the budget had already been prepared. So the real opportunity that we have, no, for putting our programs into place is the 2012 budget. Be that as it may, we're doing our best with given the constraints in the present budget.
So do you think that the administration can still recover?
Yes, of course.
And what is the government doing to make sure that it does pick up?
Well, we are working harder, and we are trying to be more focused, especially in terms of the key programs of government. President Aquino is a very performance-oriented leader. In fact, for the Philippine Development Plan, he wanted this to be tied up with the budget so that the resources will be allocated in such a way that specific indicators of performance would be monitored.
That's good.
So the performance of cabinet members will be measured by how they use their resources in meeting the objectives. Because if you look at the Philippine Development Plan, the objectives are quite formidable. Gigi, you know, we want to cut poverty in half mm-hmm. To 16% from the high of 31% in 1991. We want to achieve 7 to 8% growth in GDP mm-hmm. for the next 5 years. We also want to reduce the budget deficit. We want to increase the ratio of investments over GDP. We want to create at least 1 million jobs a year. These are very concrete performance indicators and very formidable challenges, but we are rolling up our sleeves and we're going to work as hard as it takes to accomplish these targets.
Clearly easier said than done, but yes. We wish you a lot of luck, and we thank you very much for joining us
thank
this
you,
evening.
Thank you, Gigi.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
We have to pause for our break. Strictly Politics, we'll be right back.